So the last time I played last Sunday, it was Super Bowl Sunday. So I played a bit of a longer buzzing. So I played a bit of a longer stream, and we got through. We did a couple assignments. We did the Rogue VI on the moon. I think we took out Cerberus, and or at least Cerberus for now. Spoilers. And I also did the Pharos mission. So we've done the. It was the last of the three major missions that you're kind of initially given after becoming a Spectre. So now there's a few assignments. I think I should probably head back to. Actually, what I need to do is I need to go talk to everybody now. Because after you've finished a major mission, you go talk to your entire crewmate. You need to head back to the Citadel to do some things. I did pick up a couple of assignments from kind of rumors on Pharos, so I might that are back in like the Cerberus area, so I might go check those out a bit. And then it's on to Vermeier. So we'll see if we get to Vermeier tonight. Vermeier is the next big kind of big stage to deal with. Showpiece. That's the word I was looking for. The next big showpiece. Sorry. Just getting my tea. There we go. Okay, so we've done talking to the council. And here we go. And I don't know about you, but I am starting to get very, very excited for Mass Effect Andromeda. More information's been coming out. And so it's been really excellent. Kind of hearing about all the great kind of stuff that's going to be happening in that game. I have high hopes for it. I'm tempering my hype about it. I think it's going to be an incredibly fun game. Before that, I get the next two games I've ordered is Mass Effect Andromeda, and before that, I get Horizon Zero Dawn. I am looking forward to that as well too. You should check my locker here. It's usually things. Close to my story. So what I'm gonna do. Okay, let's go talk to Liara. She's my boo. She wasn't feeling very well after the mind meld. Mind meld, because it's not Star Trek. Get the beta gels. Never know when I have to go shoot up a joint. Okay. Hello, Liara.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me? You
Worried.
look much better. How are you feeling? Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
Course, I have the best doctor on my ship.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing. I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander. I like talking with you, Liara, no matter what the subject. You have been very understanding with me, Shepard. Very patient. I appreciate that. I know there are some strange beliefs about my people. I am familiar with the legend of Asari promiscuity, but those rumors have little basis in fact. When one of my people joins with an individual from another species, it is a very deep and spiritual exchange.
Sorry, just getting a heater. It's kind of chilly in here. A proposition. We'll get to that there. Spiritual exchange.
Sound almost mystical. A true union goes far beyond an ordinary melding. It is a connection that transcends the physical universe. Two become one. Thoughts and senses merge. Identities intertwine. Memories and emotions weave themselves together, becoming entangled in a single, rapturous whole. It is unlike any other experience. In some cases, it can be a truly life-changing event.
I'm intrigued.
You Asari can live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner grows old and dies? Some units
Morbid.
Are a single encounter between two willing individuals, but there are cases where an Asari and her partner choose to remain together. When that happens, we do not focus on the inevitable loss. Instead, we enjoy the time we are given. And even after a partner has passed on, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
I'm intrigued.
Sounds amazing. Are you saying...
No. Oh, no. I am not very good at this, am I? I'm sorry, Shepard. I am trying to explain why
I have been so... me now.
Reserved. The union is more than just sex. It is the lifeblood of my species, the way we Asari evolve and grow as a society. That is why I have never... that is why we must choose our partners with great care.
It's interesting that you get, here you have, Asari, who are very, very, very open to other races because they are able to pull in other races into their culture, into their genetics, into their whole mental sphere. And they get people like the Turians, who are very rigid and strong, the Krogans, which we'll get to see a little bit more of if we get to Vermeier. We get to see a lot more of them in Mass Effect 2. The Quarians are interesting. I love the Quarians. Quarians and the Geth is probably, as I think I mentioned last time, is probably my favorite story in Mass Effect. And then you get the Salarians, and they're like pure focus, research-driven mentality. It would have been fun if there was like a storyline about like a Salarian who wanted to become an artist or something.
I want you to be absolutely sure about this, Liara.
I am only 106. Barely
only 106.
And I spend most of my time absorbed in my research. I never really thought about it. Not until I met you. You are very special to me, Shepard.
I have that way on people.
All that's happened. Saren, the Geth, the Reapers. I do not know if we are ready for this.
These are dark times, Liara. Maybe once all this is over.
I'm glad you understand, Shepard. There is too much at stake. We need to put aside our personal feelings and
focus on stopping Saren. Wait, did I just screw this up?
Saren. I wish it did not have to be that way. But we all have to make
sure. I think I just screwed that up.
Let's talk about something else.
I should go.
I think I just screwed up the relationship here. I'm actually gonna go back and... And we're going to... I'm gonna redo this conversation. I think I screwed it up. Sorry about this. Salute me. Salute me. I'm a Spectre. Different stuff this time. I can just kind of keep renewing it until I get stuff that I want, except there really isn't anything I want. Crew is pretty well equipped right now. Okay. Try this again.
Commander, are you coming to check up on
me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I like talking with you, Liara. No matter what the subject.
You have been very I know there are some... When one of my people joins with an individual from another species...
It sounds almost mystical.
A true union goes to become... It is unlike any other experience. In some cases, it can be a truly life. Some
so good,
when that happens, and even after a partner has passed on,
intrigued.
A part sounds of amazing. Are you saying? Again.
No, oh no. I am not very good at this, am I? I'm
sorry,
Shepard.
For like the tapping. It's an habit I have when I'm playing games. So things are going. I'll tap on my mouse on my keyboard. And I know the microphone picks it up. It's crazy.
It is the lifeblood of my species, the way we Asari evolve and grow as a society. That is why I have never... that is why we must choose our partners with great care.
Wait, are you saying this is your first time?
I am only 106, barely an adult by Asari standards, and I spend most of my time absorbed in my research. I never really thought about it. Not until I met you. You are very special to me, Shepard. But with all that's happened, Saren, the Geth, the Reapers, I do not know if we are ready for this.
We are.
I'm ready, if you are.
Eager is not the same as ready, Shepard. There is too much at stake. We need to put aside our personal feelings.
Okay, maybe I didn't screw up.
Focus on stopping Saren. I wish it did not have to be that way. But we all have to make sacrifices. Let's talk about something else.
Okay.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
I guess I didn't screw it up.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Is it a major mission? Is there nothing to, you guys have anything to talk to me about? Have anything in my office? Wait till part two. This becomes Miranda's office. She has a window over here. F6. I can remap that to. All this time, I'm sitting here wondering if I can remap quick save. Being used. Okay. There we go. I don't know why it was different.
Anything in
the lighting for these dialogues is so horrible for Kanan.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
I'm glad there aren't many aliens like the Thorian. I think my stomach could take it. One of my cousins has an agribusiness. I was thinking of calling him. Maybe he can get some shipments into Ferris. I mean, now that they're cut off from the company.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I didn't figure you'd have time to talk with all that's going on. There's gotta be some xenobiologists who want to read about the Thorian.
The paperwork will keep. Something on your mind?
I'm just looking for an ear. The debriefing wasn't the right place to say how ridiculous this is. Seems like every other race in the galaxy is wrapped up in their own problems. They don't want to see what's coming.
Smug aliens. We'll show them.
Wanting to believe.
Yeah, there actually is a option. Oh, we'll talk about the endings for this game. But there is an ending that could be pretty dark.
Think you'd carry a grudge over the crap you took from Vernus.
Before I met Vernus, I knew as much as any other civilian. Aliens were weird, superior, and tried to tell us what to do. I mean, it's only been 26 years since first contact. That's not a lot of time to understand them. But it was Vernus who made me see how human aliens are. They're not different or special. They're jerks and saints, just like us. Hell, by the time I got payback, I didn't even want it anymore.
I don't see you snapping very easily. What finally did it?
He hurt Rana. Broke her arm. She reached for
the glass door
instead of pulling it. Yeah, we get to
More Mass Effect 2, actually. We get to see 3. No, we get to see how they kind of treat biotics.
Didn't know what I was gonna do, just something.
Something they train. It's 3 that we actually see kind of a better route for training the biotics.
Shouting how they should have bombed us back to the Stone Age. That's when the knife came. A military issue Talon, right in my face. I cut loose. Full biotic kick right in the teeth. Almost as strong as I can manage now. At 17, that's something.
You wanted to help a girl you cared for. That's a noble thing.
Maybe my intentions were noble, but I.
Oh.
I lost control. I killed.
Guess there's no forgiving him.
Snapped his neck. They probably could have saved him if they got him to an infirmary quick enough. But they didn't. Caused a stir when they shipped him home. Bot training was shut down. Kinetics folded a couple of years later. So, yeah, maybe I hated that Turian. I mean, if one ass was enough to judge a whole race, I'd hate humans too.
A reasonable stance. True. Keep that level head and we'll do fine.
Staying reasonable is about all we've got left. Everyone else in this galaxy seems to have gone out of their minds. Present company accepted, of course.
Okay. Just sitting there, staring contest. Because they are talking. When I leave. Yeah, is what the Normandy's missing? I'm not even think I have one in my room over here. There are no bathrooms on the Normandy. Actually, I think it becomes a joke that they specifically do put bathrooms in the Normandy in Mass Effect. Because fans pointed out, it's like, hey, this whole time there's no bathrooms. Oh, Mass Effect's in terminal elevators. Yeah, the beginning is not very interesting. I'm gonna go talk to people and go do some inventory management. Then we're gonna go sell some inventory.
Commander,
So I'll get to some shooty soon.
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him.
Oh, we'll find him.
He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done. I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but if there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
I understand your concern, but we will find him. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do.
Yes, ma'am. You can count on me. Thanks for hearing me out. I appreciate it. Can I ask you something, Commander?
Of course, Garrus.
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren?
Well, Inspector.
They were already dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
I get the feeling this isn't a question. Speak your mind, Garrus.
We have other actions we can take if that happens.
We shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
That's a last resort.
Listen to reason.
Of course, we know he's going to get to that soon. I mean, he's the big villain.
Only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him.
Garrus, you're so bloodthirsty.
They might try to free him.
Okay, let's slap some sense into him.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone, but what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Maybe, maybe not, but it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yep, keep that up. Pardon me. Talk to Tally. I'm gonna talk to Rex and Ashley.
It feels like we're getting near the end, doesn't it, Shepard? With Saren, I mean.
I hope so.
It won't be much longer. One way or another, it'll all be over soon.
That or we'll be all dead.
You'll find the conduit before he does. I know you will. You have to.
Appreciate your faith in me, Tally.
This is all over. When my pilgrimage ends and I go back to my own people, I'll be proud to say I was a part of it.
One part.
I couldn't have done this without you, Tally.
You've been good to me. A lot of people treat Quarians like second-class citizens. They just want us to go back to our fleet and disappear. But you've treated me just like everyone else on your crew.
A little bit more than that. You've gone on every single mission.
And it says something about you.
Hey.
Whatever happens, I just
did take you on almost every single
mission.
I'm gonna miss you when you go back to your own people, Tally.
That won't happen for a while yet. I'll be right here anytime you need me.
Okay, nothing new there.
I should go.
See you later.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Rex! Old buddy, old pal.
Shepard.
So you'd rather be a merc than help your people?
I'm a fighter. It's what I do.
Aren't you at all worried about what will happen to the Krogan?
What the hell do you want me to do about it, Shepard?
Go down there, kick some butts, and take over the civilization.
Getting nothing for it.
So you're just giving up on your people?
I gave up on fighting for a lost cause.
I just for fights where a cause will pay him most.
You, Shepard. I'm no hero. Bottom line, killing for credits simplifies things.
Sometimes.
You ever think about helping your people?
I try not to. But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. I'm always running into them. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them. But that's just part of the job. You don't get to pick who your enemies are.
Okay.
So long, Rex.
Pretty short post-mission conversation. Okay, let's talk to Ashley, and then we're gonna do some inventory management. This is so much fun.
What's your opinion of the last mission?
Gotta admire those colonials. That's about the worst place for a colony I've ever seen. Given the option, I'd get the hell out of Dodge.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I'm off duty until tomorrow. I was gonna have a small drink. Bit of a celebration. If you're interested.
What's the occasion?
It's Armistice Day, when the first contact war ended. My family.
You think Shepard would know this?
Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
Well, I'm flattered.
Seems like an odd thing to celebrate. That was 26 years ago.
Especially since I might be killing her soon.
In our family, it's not really a celebration, more like an obligation. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
There's almost nothing in your files. Technical scores and a list of crap assignments.
There's a reason for the crap assignments.
Oh.
I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shanxi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
Now I understand.
I see. That's why you drive yourself so hard.
A Williams has to be better than the best, if only to avoid suspicion. That's what my dad told me the night before he retired. It takes a special kind of thick-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
I know Benedict Arnold. Quisling, I'm guessing, is...
What happened to your grandfather after the war?
He was relieved of command as soon as Shanxi was liberated. They brought him back to Earth in irons, but there was no...
How many people did he save by surrendering? There's the question.
He retired a year later and spent the rest of his life working construction in the colonies. Sometimes we hear about attempts to get him exonerated in some official way. Nothing ever comes of them.
As I recall, your grandfather held out for a long time.
The Turians wrecked the orbitals in the first wave and occupied the major cities. They sat in orbit, dropping rocks on anything that moved. Granddad dispersed the troops. But when they went into the cities for supplies, the Turians would wreck a block to eliminate one fire team. Civilians were dying, his troops were starving, and he couldn't contact Alliance High Command. So he surrendered the garrison.
He refused to sacrifice his men just to save face for humanity. You planning to throw yourself on a sword to save face for him?
Would it make a difference? He's gone now. Dad's gone too. And who would it impress?
Oh, foresight and knowing what's coming.
So now you know.
Conversation really interesting.
Ship skipper.
You're a valuable part of my crew, Williams. If I want an opinion from the head, I go to Alenko. When I want one from the heart, I go to you.
I also play a mean game of pool. But anyway, I've got things to do before we land. I'm sure you do too.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I should get back to my duty, Skipper. Rifles don't maintain themselves. Not yet, anyway.
Yeah, let's go meet the Geth.
Missed, Chief.
Ma'am.
Okay, now time for the very fun act of equipping everybody. Okay, pistols. Let's see. Thing up there. And. Oh, that's not a good. And so just a little bit down in damage production. Look at the shield of the tech bot. Okay, that might be. Oh, there we go. And they are look so good in pink. Okay. Tally! Actually, you should already be fully equipped. Possibly can be. Yeah. There you have. I prefer the blue. Okay. Rex, buddy, pal. Have a shotgun upgrade. Yes, so. Yeah, give it some damage. Wait a second. That one. There we go. That's more like it. Okay, that's more like it. Could give him a. Okay. Ooh, look at that. That is a huge upgrade. He's in the red. Okay. Another thing of the thing I'm a jiggy, I have another exoskeleton. You sure equipped Gaiden armor. You don't really get any. Oh, not right there. Yeah, we'll give you that. Oh, this. Yeah, do that. Okay. And Ashley. There we go. This. It's. Okay, and it's green. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Wait, this for you. Stuck. Okay, so now I can go sell a ton of shit. Basically, if I'm carrying it.
Looking for supplies?
Yes.
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander.
Almost. That's for the. Doesn't compare to what I'm correct. Oh, it sells. You can rip all this one stuff. All this three stuff. Four stuff. Five stuff. Onto that effect. My grenades. Oh, incendiary 7. Okay, I can get rid of the incendiary 6. Okay.
Looking for supplies?
Yeah.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Do I really have? I do have 1.2 million. I really don't need any of this stuff any longer. $1.8 million. Let's go by the Citadel. Buy an item in the town on the Citadel. See, this is when if I was Renegade, I'd be working to find some way to funnel all that money to a little off-planet account. Untraceable. Something in the Terminus systems. Good luck to Joker. Then we'll go do some assignments. We'll get all shooty. Joker.
Hey, Commander, next time we touch down, let's try not to park the ship in a colony of mutant zombies. Just thinking out loud here.
Okay.
How's the Normandy performing? Is she
She's the best ship balanced. The Normandy's probably too much ship for
I have to go.
You become a lot more interesting in the later games, Joker.
Yes, Commander.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
Save. Checking out properly to do with F5. And let's go. There's a couple assignments that grew up in was it which galaxy or which system was it? Bye, Pharos. The Voyager cluster. This is where we want to go. Yeah, there's things actually, I think, here. Bye, Pharos. Bye, crazy zombie plant thing. Bye, annoying Geth. I'm still never gonna get over that anime.
Commander, incoming signal from 5th Fleet HQ.
Of course there is.
Commander Shepard, something uncomfortable has just come up. In the first contact war, we fired a lot of espionage probes into Turian space. We just received a mission complete burst from one of them.
That's quite a delay.
Where's it been in the meantime?
No idea. Lost in transit. These probes were built in a hurry after first contact.
What makes this uncomfortable?
When these probes were launched, we didn't have any idea who we were fighting. We didn't want to risk aliens examining our technology. The probe has a demo nuke built in. A 20 kiloton tactical fusion warhead. About equal to the bomb dropped on Hiroshima back in the 20th. If somebody finds the probe, tampers with it. You don't need me to finish, Commander.
Yeah, that's pretty serious.
I understand this must be handled, but I don't have anyone trained to deal with this sort of thing, sir.
I know. I wouldn't ask if it wasn't important.
If Tally.
These probes have been classified for 26 years. The Council will call fusion bomb booby traps dangerous and irresponsible. The Alliance would face censure if they find this probe. I'm asking you because the Normandy can get on site quickly and quietly. It's in the Voyager cluster.
It's in the Voyager cluster? That's the opposite side of the Alliance from Turian space. How did it get there?
I don't know. It's possible someone recovered it safely and brought it there.
Well, this is interesting.
It's also possible it got very badly lost. It could have been wandering the relay network since the war.
I will clean up your mess.
We'll get on it immediately, Admiral.
But you owe me.
Be discreet.
I appreciate that, Commander. Good luck. Fifth fleet out.
Okay. I have to go find Mr. Probe. Survey. Yay, nitrogen. Save in. I found a bottom outpost insignia. Yay! So I thought we were on the opposite side of the galaxy from Korean space. So was there a Turian battalion over here? Maybe they had something to do with the bomb. Didn't say it was in the Yangtze. It's arid semi super terrestrial world. Ooh, club. Dernuka. Got Agabinium. Ooh, I can land on Agabinium. Let's see what happens. Actually, I think this is where I needed to go for the assignment I have. Garrison tally. Yeah, I should probably go do the Pinnacle Station and bring down the sky. Ooh, look at that. Okay. Map. Ion's homing beacon. Oh, that must be the probe. And we got some debris, and we got an anomaly. Okay, so let's go here. And of course, if I just drive this way, we're gonna deal with the Thresher Maws. Oh my. Oh, there we go. Oh god, look at that. That is awesome. Okay, J. Here we go. Diamonds. Espionage probe. Okay, Amazons. Okay, so that's where I'm at right now. You. Okay. Tano in the road. C. Oh. Okay. I thought there was some other things here. Okay, well, we're here. God, that is so awesome. Actually, this is the kind of thing that I still play and love No Man's Sky, to be able to kind of do this thing. I don't have a tank that I'm rolling around in. But... I still get to go around and see views like the... Ah! I just know there's a Thresher Maw in there. And I like to avoid the Thresher Maws. Is there a pain in the butt? Oop, oop, oop. Okay, you know what we need to do? Save. This is probably a trap. Oh! Look. We have a mine. Boxes that break. Garrus, I'm securing point. What I do.
The signal's coming from a mine?
Suspicious.
You think?
I agree. The probe did not crash. Someone moved it here.
They may not know what they have. Let's find it before they set it off.
Affirmative.
Try that. It's a time. gets back. Okay. Garrus, you're my way. Oh, your armor doesn't look so yellow here. There are Geth in here, or the Geth husks in here. Where am I going? Open. Seriously? So on the bomb. Yeah.
Was a detonator, Commander.
Shepard, at last.
Okay.
You have me at a disadvantage.
You don't remember me. No matter. I remember you. I never forget anyone I've fought. My name is Ilanos Heliot. I doubt you know it. Okay. Who do you think runs the Terminus Clan, Shepard, huh? Thousands of pirates, slavers, criminals of every stripe.
Who cares? What should I do?
In most criminal organizations, it's the one who's recognized as the most successful.
So analytical.
That's correct. The one who kills the most men, seizes the most ships, pillages the most colonies. 3 years ago, I was the strongest. I used my influence to assemble a fleet. We would drive your kind out of the Verge.
You're the one behind the attack on Elysium.
I was the motivator, the instigator, the one who promised glory and riches for sacking the largest human colony in the cluster. The one blamed when it failed. Failed because of you. Your damnable holding action.
My crew will come for me.
I have to call in the Normandy.
Let them. We'll be ready. An Alliance warship would make a fine prize. Oh! And if you haven't noticed, the oars here are laced with heavy metals. I'm afraid your suit radios aren't powerful enough to transmit out.
Okay. I haven't been playing Paragon, and Paragon are the top choice. I'm dealing with a criminal and a terrorist here. So, no negotiations.
We'll find a way out of here.
I rather doubt that. Goodbye, Shepard.
What do we do now, Shepard?
We've got air and light, and the Normandy's still in orbit. Let's look for another way out.
There's no time to get out. You have to disable the bomb before it goes off. Okay. Oh, dear God. Oh, crappity duck. Get it. Oh, I got it. Oop, in that one. Rapidy duck. Oh, there we go. This one. I hate this game. Have I ever mentioned that? Okay. Bomb is taken care of. So now we go this way. And we shoot up things. Because this door's. Because there's rock over there. Yeah, well, now we were blocked in here. So. Did Seriously? Wait, this is all it was? No shooty shooty. Okay. Whoa, we're like way over there. Oh no, hey, a second. Nine summon beacon. For my shields to kind of regenerate a bit.
All targets down.
No, they're not.
Perimeter clear.
Shut up, Garrus. This is almost too easy with sniper rifle. Oh, they're still croaking down there. Oh, and they're still you. Ah, these croakings just do not go down. Elliot went through a lot of trouble to draw you here. A pity it ended like this, for him at least. Now that you're above ground, your suit radio has re-established connection with Normandy. Time to get the hell out of here. Okay. I got them, Tally. Well, thank you for bringing the Mako over here. It's almost too easy with the sniper rifle and the amount of shields that I have. Here. Wait, really? I was up at the top of the hill. And I was just at. Okay, we'll just drive the Mako up here. Incendiary grenades. And let's go check out Anomaly. I always like a good Anomaly. Oh, can I blow up their car? No. That's a shame. At least I took care of the guy who started the Skillian Blitz. Sniper round through the head. Basically, Shepard's answer to that. Oh, I drove over it. Oops. Yeah, it's always funny when you fire the guns, they get onto alert. And we play this game yet again. Yay. Another thing there. Another ton of money that I really don't need. We have that much. Yeah, we're almost at 2 million. Okay, I don't think there's anything left on this planet. Back to the Normandy. Okay, so journal. Okay, so we need to go look at Matano system in the Maroon Sea cluster. Matano. Okay, so Maroon Sea cluster. That's where I need to go. Stock and Matano. Let's start with Matano. That's where the first one I have listed is.
Message coming in.
Of course there is.
Patching it through.
Commander, I'm glad you're in the area. We've got an emergency situation and you're the only one I can trust to get the job done.
Of course I'm in.
How can I help, Admiral?
Biotic fanatics have hit a medical research station with a psychotropic drug. The drugs have temporarily driven researchers crazy, and the biotics are effectively using them as human shields.
So if I shoot everything that moves, a lot of researchers are gonna die.
Exactly. A normal team could handle the biotics, but a lot of innocent researchers would die during the operation. That's why I contacted you. I'm hoping you can keep the casualties to a minimum.
I'll do everything within my power to bring those researchers back safely, Admiral.
I know you will, Commander. I'm sending you the station coordinates now. Fifth Fleet out.
Remember this? Okay. To pay. Okay. Asteroid belt. Okay. Unknown. Rocky asteroid. Yay, Prothean data disk. Spelt. Okay. The next one. Ilapa. Apo. Okay, scan the asteroid belt. Alcastro. Jessica. Okay, we can land on this planet. We'll come back to Jessica. Take a look at Inti. Okay. There's supposed to be a station somewhere. Go to Jessica and land, and we'll look at the assignments. Deep blue sky for once. Which means no awesome, like, starscapes in the sky. Okay, mapping. Okay, so we got an anomaly, we got a civilian structure, a science facility, and debris. Check out the anomaly before we do. Sieged base. Hades Gamma Cluster in the area then. This one, right? This is the one. Ton of system. Place to search. Okay. Let's go this way. Crash. Come on, Miko. You got it. You got it. See, this is really what the future technology consists of, is a kick-ass transmission in a vehicle like this. Slap this baby into low gear, and there's nothing it can't tackle. There we go. Oops. Come on. Come on. Seriously. Seriously. Okay. This again. Go this way. Go this way. There we go. There we go. Good Mako. I knew you could do it. Get an extra pint of oil when we get back. I found another pyramid. Don't get run over, Telly. There's lots of things over here. Go up and take a look at the top of this. Oop. Eee. Okay, if we can, let's recover the crate. Data disk. Ah, okay. What? Oh, why did I do that? I have enough on me, Joe. I really need any of it. Extension another room, another minute. There we go, gotcha. Light armor, light armor. Is it any good? No, it's not good. That is an upgrade, isn't it? That is a significant upgrade. Yes. Done on you. There you go. My sound just, that was weird. Like the music just like abruptly cut out. That was odd. Okay. That pretty. Okay, so where to next? Check out this debris. Oh. Back up, beep, 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 beep. Three-point turn in the Mako. Yeah, this is probably not going to be a good way to go live. Oop. Hey! Okay. Diagonal. Remember, always drive across diagonals. Because for some reason that screws up the physics. Oh. Oh, something up over there. Okay. Up the mountain? Wait, okay, so I need to go somewhere this way. Oh, wait. Yeah, we're gonna do. We're gonna take care of this facility. We'll get over to the debris later. Crash. Hello, dude. Oh.
Colony must have been transformed.
There you are. That's a dandelion fluff. Okay, we got some pus.
Looks deserted.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Yeah. It's Indiana Jones' line. I've got a bad feeling about it. Or is it Han Solo? It's Han Solo that's a bad feeling. Yeah. Okay. Let's go kill some husks. Why is he typing on the console? They are. Did I break the AI here? Oh, die! Yeah, run away! What happens when you have jacked up weapons like this? And armor.
Hello.
Oh, love glove. That's nice. Sludge canister. Why would I want to open a sludge canister? That's why I'd want to open a sludge canister. Still probably not. Yeah. Nice rifle, but it's like, okay. Allie, thank you. Harris, thank you. That's better. Okay, that's not okay. Yes, and I know everything's probably dead, but still, okay. Fire 7. Nothing else, dudes. Let's head back. Let's see if we can get some more Geth husks to glitch on the cover. And just kind of sit there like that. For me to kind of mow them down. Ablative coating, so Garrus, what do you have in your armor? Keep you with that. You tend to die more. Okay. Take care of the other civilian. Oops. I guess I already killed them. That's what happens when I shoot from far away.
Cover me.
No, Tally, you cover me. You're the one with the shotgun. I'm the precision shooter. What is the point of that? Why is that there? Ooh, there's lots of bad guys here. Come on. Seriously? I see you. Okay, yep, you guys take care of that. There we go. This is gonna be the Geth, or these guys. They just come right at you. Bye. Ooh, there's another one still. Tally, what are you doing? Basically, this whole thing is just an excuse to get a whole bunch of loot, which I don't really need at this point. I've had the same problem like the Dragon Age games. Like Dragon Age Inquisition, I ended up like getting to a point with the armor, like I was able to craft my own armor and weapons. But anything I picked up was just useless. I'm actually even having like really early on in the game, I picked up the sword that was shaped like a hand. I did the whole quest that got that. And I used that thing forever because there just wasn't a sword that matched what that one could do. You. Oh. I don't think I have any. Oh, wait. Probiotic. No, you're not. Okay, well, I'll get for our biotics when I get back. I actually do love how they kind of show the possible spread of bullets and kind of accuracy moving wise. Here, without me aimed in, this is the size. Oh, here we go, moving. Here's the size of my reticle. Stopped, there it is. Admit, look how fine it is. Start moving, there we go. It's, and then actually, watch this. Smaller. Admit, look at that. Just kind of a nice little interface technique they put into there. Need anything else? I'm not gonna kill myself and stuff. We will go up to the science facility and go some more husks. Go, there you are. Okay, need to go up here. So one thing that's kind of interesting to note is tonight The Walking Dead came back, but to give a sense of how much I have kind of fallen off watching it, used to be appointment TV for me. Like I would have everything done and ready so I could just sit back, relax, and watch The Walking Dead. At 9 o'clock on Sundays. And with this past season, I just not liked the whole Negan character thing. And so I'm just not that interested. So I'm here playing this game tonight, and I'll go watch it on the DVR. So it's become not live TV for me. Have to be careful that you can't actually park the Mako so close that you can't actually get into the door. Then you have to get back in the Mako. Drive it a bit. Okay. More good spikes. I remember having trouble with this before. At this point, I'm not gonna have trouble. They can only come from this way.
Hostile spotted.
Oh, that would do. Oop. There we go. Oh. Oh, there's my grenade. Okay. I didn't think they could come this way. Apparently they could. Fortunately, my squad is good. I'm good. Eat it. I have what's known as stopping power. This weapon. Really? Seriously? It's an empty room. Okay. It's always so anticlimactic when I get to this point and there's like nothing left. Shoot. I just get to like, I basically get a treasure room. Colonial Pioneer team is rarely consists of more than a few dozen specialists. It's clear that none of them have survived. Cerber's group has a lot to answer for here. Is it a good thing that I've kind of shut them down already? No. I think we're done. There might be some bad guys on the way out. Who knows? We'll see. Probably not. It would make for a good surprise. We've just essentially wiped out the entire company. Which is very sad. Try to get all these things. See if we can get up to here. I think like up at the top of that hill, isn't it? No, it's actually right about. Oh, right over there. I always think I need to be on top of the hills for this. No. No. Open area. Better not be a Thresher Maw. I'm not getting through this one. Oh, wait, wait. Oh, not getting up. Okay. Ooh. Allie. Modular. Improvement for this. Give you this actually. Yeah. Okay, I think we're done on this planet. Yep. Okay. I guess maybe I'm not getting to Vermeier tonight. We'll just do some more assignments and go to the Citadel. Okay, so we're done with the Matana one. So now we're going to go on. Now, here to Vostok. I wonder how I'm doing on the collection things.
Looks like we've got an active distress beacon on the planet below, Commander. No message, just a locator signal.
Okay. Insect analogs grow to frightful sizes. We'll come back to you. Oh, Marthu. Okay. So, just one second. I have to go use the restroom, and then I'll be right back. So enjoy the music. Okay, I'm back. Sorry for that. Let's go check out this distress beacon on Nudacrux. And we get to be on another pretty planet. Boom. This planet looks exactly like the last planet. Yeah, we're in a completely different system. Okay, so we got an anomaly, science facility. Let's go check out the anomaly. There is something over there. Why are there bad guys over here? Go check them out. Oh. There are a lot of bad guys over here. Thorians. Oh. Yeah, I'm just pushing his body around. Well, we've got our old friend the Thorians here. Why are these guys here? A underground facility that I can't get into. You know, this is my third time playing this game and remember this. Okay. The other ones. Yeah, run away. Oh, I can't get into the hardening crate. Oh, hey, look, we got something new for play, maybe. Is that both? Oh, no. Okay. Well. Okay, sniper rifle. Allie. This one. Hello, next 7. Have an upgrade. Okay, so let's switch to the anomaly again. But we got the Thorians over here. Cerberus, what are you doing? Guess we should maybe go check over this pole. Just in case. Save again. Okay, so let's go check out the anomaly. Leave the science facility for last. This is just asking for a Thresher Maw. Today? Okay. And we're gonna fall down the hill backwards. This is where I'm gonna be. Let's go for the Thresher Maw. I don't know if they show up on grassy planets. Save before, just to make sure. How did the Thorian get here? I guess I'll find that out. Oh, because Cerberus brought it over. That's right, because it was the whole samples. They got out. Yada, yada, yada. Science overreaching. Same old story. Perfect, now next, I was expecting the Geth.
Cover me.
No, for me. Play the mini game again. Brain insignia. Yay. Okay, so we did it. Took out three. Wait a minute, like, almost the back corner of the map here. This is my operational area, Joker would call it. Can we get up the hill? Can get up. We are getting up the hill. There we go. Right at the bottom of this hill. Right. Go bounce, bounce. Yep, there it is. Those things. I feel like I'm in No Man's Sky now. Those are kind of creepy. If they're hostile. Talk. I can talk to it. Weird. At least they're not trying to kill me. Why can I talk to them? I'm not saying anything. What the hell are these things? I could probably take the makeup. Let's play the game again. Ooh. This one. Oh, nope. Not making it on this one. So random. Goodbye, weird creatures. Come on, can I make a... Yes, 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 you got it. Good boy. Good boy. There we go. Now, after all that work, you got some nice easy driving up here. I always feel like there's like a lot of secrets that I'm missing, because I just kind of come into these planets, do like the bot missions. I don't do my normal like exploration route. You know what I want to do? We're gonna get out and actually like kill. There is a long, oh my god, there's a long drop and I almost fell down it. Okay, that's good. Science gun. How do they drive those like low vehicles around on this planet? I mean, I have a tank and I'm having trouble getting around. Little bar there. I whipped it out of place. And they just brought it back here.
I smell trouble.
I think we're just gonna sit here and let them kind of come in. Save so I don't have to kill them again. Here, so again, really anticlimactic. Expecting there to be more in there. Just had that one. Stuff that they don't need. Crawlers. That's it. With that. Sure, why not? Sludge canister. Reaper 8. Another bio. The money again. Stuff I do not need at this game.
Rescuers? Oh, thank God. See? I told you somebody would come to investigate that signal. My name is Dr. Ross, Chief Exogeny Researcher at this facility. We've been trapped in this room for days. We're almost out of food and water. You got here just in time.
I need to know what's going on. Why is this place crawling with Thorian creepers?
How do you know about the Thorian?
I killed it.
I know what Exogeni was up to. I saw what they let the Thorian do to those colonists, so I destroyed it.
Our secret's out then. No point in my lying. You already know the worst. The creepers here were created using altered samples from the specimens on Pharos. We discovered a way to turn them into docile, obedient servants.
Yeah.
Everything was going fine until a few days ago. Then all the creepers suddenly went berserk. Only a handful of us made it back into the safety of this room.
Oops. It may have been my fault.
Why didn't you send a clear message asking for help? All we had was that signal from the emergency beacon.
This is a closed communications base. Exogeni was worried about someone on the project selling secrets to a rival firm or reporting our work to the authorities. We have no direct communication with the outside, only the emergency beacon. It sends a general distress signal to the Exogeni site on Pharos. They're supposed to send a team to respond inside of 24 hours, but it sounds like they had problems of their own.
She sounds like she's from North Dakota.
Any chance some of the other people at the base might still be alive?
I doubt it. Too many creepers out there.
This guy in the armor back there.
We're the only ones left.
Any idea why they turned on you?
Maybe there was still some kind of link between the creepers and the Thorian back on Pharos. The Thorian was unlike any other life form we've ever studied. I can't explain how, but maybe when it died, it somehow set off the creepers here.
I've heard all I need to.
Look, I know what we did here was wrong. I'll admit that. But it's over now. There's no sense reporting this to the authorities, right?
Lost
their
lives.
You were in charge of this project. The safety of the staff was your responsibility. They trusted you, and you betrayed that trust.
Be reasonable. I didn't mean for this to happen. Besides, how does it help anyone if I end up in jail? Normally, Exogeni would have my back, but it sounds like they're going to have their hands full cleaning up the mess on Pharos. But I've got money. A nice little emergency fund I set up. It's yours if you let us go.
The victims here deserve justice. I have to take you in.
That's not going to happen. Open fire. Open fire!
Dudes, keep stop moving around. Exogeni's second rank perks proved no match for a trained Alliance Marine. With the last of the science crew dead, there's no reason to linger here. Although this pause with the, Well, I tried. God, we got a lot of biotic amps all. Wow, I picked up, what, 600,000 out here? Let's go. What else can I add? Don't really need you, but anyway. Or was there one more thing I need to go look at on this planet, or was this? This may have been it. Check the Hades Gamma Cluster and try to rescue the people from the crazed biotics. Yeah, I think I'm gonna save Vermeier for next week. So I'll go do all the other random stuff you keep giving me. Seat base, that's the. This 8 of 6. to have... No, it seems like I found a lot more of these than that. Those are the ones I keep... We're going to... Shohei. Cacus system gamma. Probably lots of. We're back to the Normandy and onward. Okay, so Hades Gamma. Armus. What's he in there? Baron Gore. Hey, you. Plenium. Yeah, that's right. Three. Yay. Okay, so let's go to Chuck. Bird facing together. So it is nearly a vacuum. Atmosphere allows more. I found it. Okay. Oop, we get another cool sky. Okay, we are pushing our territory again. Okay, so we got a science base and center closer. Let's go check you out. Get a little save in here in case something does decide to pop up and kill me. But it's Geth. You think it's Geth? It could be Geth. Fuel tank. Or fuel tank. So all done here. I'm still blowing that thing up. It scared me. Okay, matriarch writing. Yay! Stuff I don't need. Okay, oh, matrix writing. It looks like someone has been living in this place. The small crate held some stale food and what a Dylanaga's right. So I found matriarch Dylanaga. I have the app. I have clear who owns this container. But that was weird. Whatever. It screwed me up. Eris, get out of the way. Look to the transmitter. Your comms pick up a recording of a wistful string quartet. You power the system down. Whoever lived here, they haven't been back for some time. The crates are covered with Chohei's chalky dust, and the status lights of the shack indicate its atmosphere ran out long ago. Oh, it's a mystery. Hey, you're far enough away. Come on, Garrus, get out of my way. That was satisfying. That was so satisfying. I had to do that. Okay. Let's go check out the science base. Go this way. This is just asking for a thresher maw. Here's the base on the other side. So we're just gonna kind of skirt this whole area here. Yes, I don't like Thresher Maw. I don't like fighting them. Down the terrace, but remember to check your targets. Civilians are so addled by the drug they might wander into the middle of a firefight. Oh, wonderful. I almost actually want you guys to just stay here. Sorry about that, phone buzzed. Okay, remember guys, don't shoot the friendlies. Okay, okay.
Hostile spotted.
I hope we did. Nope. I killed a researcher.
All clear.
Researcher's killed.
I can't stop it. I can't stop it. It's all spinning away.
At least it's only one. Oh shit. I missed what that said. I think I killed another one. Aww. You've neutralized the threat posed by the biotic. Try it again. We could. I can just continue on. Yeah, let's not do it again. Just got hit. I have so much more stuff to sell.
Where is it? Did you see it? It was just here. So beautiful.
spill out. And then I won't be me anymore. I won't be me if it all spills out. I have to hold still.
Theater. I lose them. Oh well. There's some debris to go check out. I'll go do that now. This planet is actually pretty easy to drive on. There's a great. Minerals on our way there. Let's get. Let's see what happens. Yep, thought so. Come on. Where are you? Oh. Do we know there's one in there? Should I try it again? Let's try that one more time. Come on. I know you're here somewhere. Oh, fuck. Yeah, that was not good. I drove right at it. I need to keep out of that zoomed out screen. This one. Come on. Shit, shit, shit. There it is. Shit. Thank you. Come on. Come on, you bastard. Shit, 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 shit. Get away from here. My tires. Look at this bitch. As long as he doesn't like just come up like right in front of me again. There we go. Driving across flat areas was bad. Near around 7. Okay, how does that looks interesting. What I just got. Upgrade my incendiary rounds. Because that is what we need. Back to the Normandy.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
I guess not going to be happy.
Work, Commander. You took down the biotics with minimal collateral damage.
I killed innocent people today, Admiral. The biotics set it up, but I pulled the trigger.
The biotics had every advantage, including human shields. You lost a handful of civilians. Any other unit I sent in would have lost dozens of innocent lives. You saved a lot of lives today, Commander. Fifth Fleet out.
Okay, I guess I'll take it. So, I think onto the Citadel. I don't think I have any assignments left. Check out some of these other planets and see if there's things to go up. So, let's go take a look. I'm gonna do a check it out kind of thing. Okay. Toma. Wait, apparently I have been system. Yeah. In this system before. We got Antaeus. One of the things I like about Aspect 2 is you start getting a kind of a status indicator of how much you've explored a system. I don't know why I always do them from outside in. Oh look, I can land on this planet. Loba. Is it Jupiter Brain, a planet-sized supercomputer? Okay, hold on. Loba is the second and by far the larger of Antaeus's two gas giants. Active scans by survey ships have returned tantalizing indications of a massive solid structures deep within the atmosphere, too regular in pattern to be anything natural. Some believe Loba is a Jupiter Brain, a planet-sized supercomputer. Adherents of this theory have fruitlessly beamed signals towards the sunken megastructures, hoping to get the machine's attention. Others believe that the ancient spacefaring race disposed of their weapons of war by dumping them in the planet. The last attempt to reach and salvage Ploba's deep anomalies went tragically wrong, ended with a crew of 12 being trapped and crushed in the gas giant's lower atmosphere.
Ish.
Isn't that interesting, though? Oh, this is a pretty planet. Interesting seeing gas giants so close to... We have a terrestrial planet here. During the initial survey of the Anatea system, only a single flyby probe was spared for the small scorched world of Gecko. It revealed a planet unusually rich in heavier elements given its size. It's a standard terrestrial world. Due to extremely rough crater terrain, starships are discouraged from landing. Shouldn't stop the Mako though. I guess I can't land there. But we can land on Trevin. Let's go see what's on Trevin. I don't think I've ever done this before. Usually I just kind of stick with the storyline and the assignments that I get assigned to me. Okay, so it's kind of a deserty planet. This guy looked like, come on, was on the planet invisible. Wait, pervade, I've been here before. Back to the Normandy. Sorry. Plutus. Let's go take a look at Plutus. I don't think I've run to Plutus. Maybe it's a system I haven't checked out yet. Maybe I have. Who knows? I've kind of lost track at this point. They are in. And that would be why I haven't been able to survey anything on these planets. Apparently I didn't pay attention to this Jupiter brain thing before, because that was really interesting. That's a really interesting science fiction kind of plot line there. Annual effect. There was a series of books by Kevin J. Anderson, who worked often with Brian Herbert on the continuation of the Dune series. But Kevin Anderson, not a great series. I only read the first three or four books, so it's good enough they got me that far. But it starts off with humans have gone out into the stars, they've met other alien races, and they develop a technology that allows them to turn a gas giant, basically trigger fusion in its core, and turn it into like a small sun, which then allows them to terraform the moons around the gas giant. And in doing so, they accidentally like destroy city of a civilization of gas giant dwelling aliens, who then promptly declare war on humanity. And it ends up pulling in, you end up, there's like a whole like tree-based intelligence that gets pulled into it there. There's like water-based, it ends up being like almost like elemental. You have your earth aliens, you have your tree aliens, you have your water aliens, your air aliens. Really strange. I never finished it. I'm kind of intrigued by it, but maybe I should go back and try it out. But yeah, so that idea of something in gas giants, because we can't get down to the pressure's so high, the temperatures are so high, because essentially a gas giant is a lot of gas giants like Jupiter is a failed star. It just did not have enough mass to ignite fusion. So there's a lot of like interesting things that can happen with. We look at Jupiter and like the mysterious clouds and the storms and the great red spot and the stripes that are on Jupiter. There's just storms and the prevailing winds. It's really, really fascinating stuff. Okay, so we are on Nanua, which we can land on. I probably have already been here. We'll come back to Nanua. Lacralis. No, I haven't been in the system yet, because I would have surveyed this planet if I had been. Maidla. Mingito. More uranium. Sun-baked wasteland of sodium, corates, and radioactives. That's why I have uranium. Okay, so I'm tickling manual. Apparently I can land here. Okay. Pretty skies at least. Very rocky planet. Oh, look at that. Watch. Yeah. Come on. Lens flare. Oh, you're not gonna give it to me again? Ah, there we go. I'm like J.J. Abrams. Lens flare. There it is. Okay. Enough dicking around. Anomaly, debris, Warlord's Outpost. Okay, go check that out. Got the anomaly. We'll go take down a Warlord. You know why? Because I'm a Spectre. Well, this planet does not look very welcoming. There is a cabin here, all by its lonesome. Why is this here? It does have a fuel tank. And there's a car. Oh, there's a corpse.
On my way.
Dude, they have floating cars. Why don't I have a floating car? Get out of my way, Tally. League of One medallion. There's no indication of me. Examine the crate. Judging by the footprints in the ash, the two mercenaries were facing each other over the crate when they died. Both suffered single gunshot wounds and a rifle close beside them. Try and open the crate, you discover a carefully wrapped handwritten copy of one of Matriarch Dilanaga's treatises. It is unlike who she penned it herself, but the flowing brushwork and intricate watercolor illustrations clearly show the hands of a man of the tribe. Okay. Grenades. Dudes are dead. Okay. Well, that was easy. Let us continue on to the debris then. Really cool planets that you're on that you actually see, because they actually have, like debris falling from the sky, but you actually look up and there's just like meteorites. It's so awesome. There's a lot wrong with this game. There's a lot good with this game. Some of the things like this is just beautiful. Being able to get onto the planets and look around like this. Of course, I could always go play No Man's Sky for that. And I promise I will play No Man's Sky at some point on the channel. Okay, let's get a little bit closer. Let's get mind-boggling. Oh, boy. Oh, there we go. Loading crowd. Cell. Ow. You gotta kick a warlord's butt. It's a proper shooty. Basically guys that will shoot at us and we don't have to worry about civilians. Basically a nice clean fight where three people take out like 20. There not be a Thresher Maw up here. Thank you. sounds. Weird sounds going on. I know. Hey, hold on, hold on. Hear that? It's like a pulsing sound. Go survey the minerals there. Samarium. Some reason, like the action wasn't working. Or did I like wake them up and they're like shooting at things? They don't know where I'm at. They have tanks too. Mine's better than yours.
I'm on my way.
Planet sounds creepy. Inside. Hello. Hello. I'd like to kill you.
You lead, I'll follow.
Hello. Seriously not letting me in? Knock knock. Back door? Hello? Back door? Okay. It's not working either. It's over here. Well, that was disappointing. Expecting a fight. They don't even open their doors. Should have the Normandy come and blow him up. We have a pool of lava over here. Wow, look at this. Okay, go back to the... Expecting a little bit more fun for that place. Wait, did I find all of the writings of the matriarch? There's all the Asari writings. Huh. Huh. Okay. Well, nothing left to do in this system. Kinda disappointing. Go back to Citadel. Wait. Okay, I'm gonna play for about a half hour more. Just go kind of visit some sites around the Citadel. I don't really have anything I have to hand in. Go look around a bit. I don't really want to Vermeier yet. So we have Vermeier. And we have the Pinnacle Station DLC, which I don't think I've ever played before. I ended up getting it. I wonder when did I get it? I can't remember when. I think maybe I bought it when I started this again, so I would have them all. I've done the Sky one, whatever it's called. I've done that one. And we'll do that one also. So I have those two DLC missions. I've heard the Pinnacle Station one's really not that great, but I'll play it. I've never played it before. And then there's Vermeier, then there's Ilos.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior. Interior atmosphere.
Oh, he doesn't have his yellow armor.
Logged. The commanding
his armor matches mine.
Is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
And then there's Ilos, and then there's the final battle. There's not much. I just don't want to kind of burn it all yet. Though I still have two more games to play after this. Did we pick up any more assignments?
After years of poor economic performance, Exogeny has announced that its research colony on Pharos is finally returning a profit. New discoveries and a dedicated colonization effort have finally paid off for Exogeny.
Amazing what happens when you actually do something properly.
With the announcement, with investors pleased at this surprising news.
Enter between. Ooh, Citadel. Well, Citadel. Hello, CSAC. Look, another elevator.
Presidium technicians are struggling to understand why a computer system catastrophically overloaded recently. Technicians are reportedly unsure of what caused the malfunction, or
oh,
even what
yeah,
the system
I did
was
that.
Originally designed to do. CSEC is investigating the possible vandalism or misuse of public property.
Oops. Oh, Mass Effect and its elevators. Well, eesh. This would be a great killing corridor. I'd be surprised if these things here are like weapons or something. Anybody trying to take CSEC? Jeesh. Oh, well, a little thingamajiggy.
Hey, Commander Shepard. Good to see you again. Anything you need?
I have to go.
Right. You're probably real busy. Well, see you around, Commander.
Yeah. Busy. Not really. I mean, I have to go save the galaxy and all, but... But, yeah. So, waiting for somebody? What are the doctors doing? Hello, Dr. Bell.
I need those supplies for my clinic. I can't.
Oh.
You can and you will, or your story won't stay secret for long. Don't disappoint me, Doctor.
Oh, Commander Shepard, I didn't see you come in.
Every time I come in here, I see someone threatening me. Who was that?
Someone from my past. I can take care of it.
I might be able to help you.
I was fired by my previous employer for giving out free medical supplies to clinics like this. They never filed any charges, they just wanted me to leave without any fuss. But somebody must have found out. Now they are blackmailing me. I have to give them what they want. If the board finds out about my past,
it sends me back to that warlord.
They'll shut my clinic down.
Stronghold? I'd be a little pissed. I can help you,
maybe,
but a friend.
I can get you out of this. Tell me what they want.
I have to give some of my medical supplies to a merchant in the markets. They expect delivery today.
Give me your contact's name. I'll deal with this guy, whoever he is.
Yeah, you could go shoot
deal
somebody.
With him, but won't they expose my past?
I'll make sure they don't tell anyone.
I was told to speak with a merchant named Morlin down in the markets. I really appreciate this, Commander. Thank you.
Problem. I'm gonna say I need supplies. Actually,
let me take a look at what you have for sale.
I have so much money. Exoskeleton. Oh, wow. I'm looking at 386,000 credits. I have 2.7 million. Oh, hello. Now. Plus 50%, okay. Better health regeneration. Plus power, which I don't ever use. Still. I remember the good old days when I had a shootout in this clinic. Need it. Medigel. We have something to do. Let's go. In the market. Oh, and eat. Over here in the corner. Hey, can I join in? Hello? Yes. It's part of me.
Oh, sure. I can return that. Thanks. Hasn't worked well since I bought it.
Hey, are you refunding his stuff?
Here you go. Your account will be credited.
You did! You took his return! Look, I'm telling you, I bought this here. Why won't you return it?
I can't take it back unless...
I know. Unless I have a proof of purchase.
That's good. You need to have a receipt for returns. So if you're going to buy something that you want to return, always keep the receipt. Or just don't return it. Don't be a dick when you go to a store. Morlin. Shoot Morlin. Oh, there he is. Dude, you're into some shady stuff.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous shop. You want many good supplies, yes?
You were expecting a delivery of medical supplies.
But I was told the doctor would be bringing them.
Things have changed, Morlin.
Okay, going, Telly.
The doctor... I don't... This is not right, human.
Shut up, Moreland. I told Baines you'd screw this up. What the hell's going on here? Who are you?
Your worst nightmare. You know, playing the Renegade sometimes can be really fun, but...
Leave the doctor alone.
We can end this if you just bring me those supplies. Otherwise, I'll start telling people about the doctor's little secret.
Oh, can I talk out of this? I can.
You're shutting down a medical clinic. What if someone needs treatment? What if you need treatment?
Shoot him.
Hey, hold on. I'm just the middleman here. This is way more than I bargained for.
Good to shoot him.
Thank you, human. It is good to see him humbled so.
What do you know about Baines?
I have never met him, human. I only worked with the one who spoke with the doctor.
What do you know about Baines?
I have never met him, human. I only worked with the one who spoke with the doctor.
What do you know about Baines?
I have never met him, human.
Okay.
I only worked with the one who spoke with the doctor.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Yes, all right then. Good tidings to you, human.
My map got updated. Office of... Seriously. Okay, so now I have to go talk to the doctor again. I still didn't get to shoot somebody. First the warlord. And now this guy. I guess I could have just failed to shoot him, but... Wanna shoot somebody. And I'm like running all around. Can't even get a car. Shepard, damn it. Well, Baines.
Commander, how did things go?
As expected, because I'm a badass.
Really? That's a great relief, Commander. Thank you. I can't pay you for your help, but I can give you a discount on any supplies you purchase here.
Could have waited. About my medical skeleton.
A thug said he worked for a man named Baines. Sound familiar?
Baines? I wonder if he means Armiston Baines. We worked together a long time ago.
What can you tell me about him?
Last I heard, the Alliance military was contracting him for some research in the Traverse.
We should follow up with Captain Anderson.
Good idea.
We'll see what the captain can tell us.
I wish I could tell you more. Is there anything else I can help you with, Commander?
I'll be going now.
Goodbye, Commander. Nice talking to you.
Oh, you know what I realized? I leveled up. I leveled up like a long time ago. I didn't do it. In fact, I am really close to another level. Okay, so... Yeah, let's update this. What I need, more health. He's all the way up in sniper rifles. I could have him be using. Actually. ARS. Look at sniper rifle. Ooh. G44. I mean, it's not my sniper rifle. Sniper rifle, but. Look, the Volkov 7 has been. Yep. That looks like. Give you some Cindy. Okay, so. I'll find him in the end. Yeah. We should go back and say hi to the consort. We have arrived at the Brazilian embassies. Let's save. A little bit Mass Effect 2 when I get to that, a little bit different. Person. Did I break it again? No. Oh, Eudena, you probably love the fact that I'm breaking.
I saw your Ferris report. If we had known anything about the Thorian, Exogeny would never have been given the permits to start a colony there.
Sure.
Thank God the colony survived. We can't afford to have too many failures out in the Traverse. It's one of our major expansion regions.
You don't give a damn about the colonists. It's all just politics to you, isn't it?
We can't all be the hero who charges in to save the day, Commander. But we each serve humanity in our own way. You can't escape interstellar politics. It's part of the big picture. Sometimes
I think I do get to shoot him. Some point in the, I get the opportunity. I think it's a
just
renegade action.
The ambassador's a little bitter sometimes. Comes with the job.
Now I conduct you.
Yes, Commander.
Investigate. Baines.
What do you know about Armistead Baines?
Where did you hear that name? Never mind. I don't want to know. Baines is dead. Has been for quite some time.
The people I spoke with seem to think he was still alive.
It's not common knowledge. Military is keeping it under wraps. Baines was doing some high-level work for the Alliance. Stuff even I wasn't aware of. One day he turns up dead on a drifting scout ship. Everyone suspects it was foul play, but it was never officially investigated.
What can you tell me about the ship?
I don't know much about it. You should talk to Admiral Kohoku. One of his crews discovered Baines' body.
Isn't he dead?
I spoke to Kohoku. He never brought it up.
You should mention Baines the next time you see him. See if he'll tell you anything.
I think I may have.
Is there anything else, Commander?
I think I may have broken this quest line. Because I think Kohoku's dead now. Hey.
Do you know anything about Vermeer?
Sorry, Shepard. I've never even heard of it before all this. You'll have to go out there and check it out for yourself.
Where can I find Admiral Kohoku?
Last I heard, he was up in the tower trying to get the council to investigate Baines' death. Is there anything else, Commander?
But Baines has been dead for years. Why has he been up in the council tower the entire time?
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Okay. Lead. Yeah, he's dead. So, yeah, that's kind of a broken quest line. Oops. Well, know about it now. I think I've ever done that quest. Unless that was all tied into the Cerberus thing. Took care of it through kind of a... When I'm done here, I might look that up a bit. Can you imagine all the water? I mean, this much water in space is mind-boggling. And trees. So if you go see, Messengers. Dude, where'd you come from? You see Passenger. There's a little bit of that in there. Sign. Dude, all by yourself. Getting slick. Okay, yeah, we're almost. Yeah, so it looks like next week.
Who are you to tell me what my husband would want?
I'm the
only person making sense right now. You're endangering your baby.
This baby is the only thing I have left of Jake.
Like I'm watching a soap opera.
I don't care what you think, Michael. It's my decision.
I know you're hurting, Rebecca, but don't let your grief hurt your baby too.
Can I help with anything?
Come on, Spectre.
Perhaps you can talk some sense into her.
I don't need anyone to talk sense into me, Michael. I'm not undergoing the treatments.
My sister-in-law here is pregnant, and she's refused to let the baby undergo gene therapy in utero.
I'm certain that she has a good reason. I'd like to hear both sides.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's her baby, her body.
My husband died from a rare heart condition several months ago.
There's a chance that the baby could develop the same heart condition, but routine gene therapy can eliminate it.
A very small chance, Michael. And extranet reports say the therapy could harm the child.
It's less dangerous than the genetic enhancements that every soldier in the Alliance receives.
Are you looking up medical advice on the internet? Really? Don't look up medical advice on the internet. Please. Don't. I, as a librarian, an expert in research and looking up information, if you're really serious about something, call your doctor. Let's see.
Jeez. What are the chances that your child will develop the heart condition?
Why am I deciding
According
this?
According to the doctors, there's a 1 in 50 chance. And if my baby develops the condition, medical treatments are available.
Which are nowhere near as effective as simply getting the gene therapy.
What are the chances that gene therapy could hurt the baby?
1 in 300 at most.
But extranet articles say there could still be long-term complications we don't know about. Don't you understand? If my baby is that 1 in 300, I will always wonder if I killed my baby for nothing.
And a pro-choice person, let her choose.
It's Rebecca's child, Michael. I think you should honor her decision.
Mm-hmm.
Damn it, she's not choosing. She's acting blindly out of grief.
Still her choice.
I know you want the best for your brother's child, but this is not your decision.
Of course it is! I'm the closest thing to a father this baby is going to have.
Then support the baby's mother. Stand with her when she
makes
the tough
decisions. I don't think I ever
did
this before.
This baby is the only thing my brother... It's all I have left of him. I need to know that the baby's safe.
It's all I have left too, Michael.
I just want Jacob's child to be safe. I want to give him that much.
We will.
There's treatments for the medical.
Thank you for talking with us.
We're living in like what, the 27th century here? Oh, hello. Yeah, I think I've maxed out the Paragon. There is no more Paragon to get. Okay, we got another point. As well, finish off shock. Yay! Mr. Sabotage. Okay. Was a sort. Never did that before. Mr. Shadow Broker. Shadow Broker's.
Greetings.
I should bring Liara to come meet him.
I believe congratulations are in order, Commander Shepard. You are the first human to join the Spectres, yes?
Thank you.
It's a great honor.
One you are no doubt ready for. A word of warning, though. There are many eyes watching you now, Commander.
Hey, you could have...
Some of them want to see you fail.
I love when she looks over her shoulder there.
I, however, wish you only success. Perform well and you bring the Earth Clan one step closer to joining the Council. And if they let your people in, maybe there is hope for my own species one day, yes?
You know, I wonder, do we bring the fullest with us to the Andromeda, in the Andromeda Initiative? Find out about this.
I should go.
Oh, but the reason I mentioned about bringing Liara here is that Liara becomes the Shadow Broker. Spoilers. I love Blake.
Got a moment, Spectre?
You're just waiting for me here to randomly walk by over on this side of the pond? Because, you know, I haven't really been walking around the Citadel. Okay.
Hello, Spectre. I have a business proposition for you.
How did you know I'm a Spectre?
Word travels. Your name comes up in certain circles. I'm acquainted with a pair of powerful crime bosses. They're hiding on remote worlds, and I have the coordinates. You could do the galaxy a favor.
Remember that warlord fort, kind of warlord stronghold that I just visited? This is the quest for it. So we're gonna have to go back there.
And what do you get out of this?
We share interests in certain cooperative ventures. But their business practices have forced me to terminate our relationship. Once they are dead, I will manage our organization in a more tasteful manner.
What crimes did these men commit?
They're red sand dealers who make victims of their customers. Those who can no longer pay are sold to Batarians as slaves. They're loathsome, hurting innocent people. They must be ended.
I eliminate them and then you take over and try to eliminate me. How stupid do I look?
While I appreciate your estimation of my bravado, I have no intention of attempting to murder
you. Sure you
me.
Don't.
You are the first human Spectre, and you are doing important work for humanity. I have no interest in red sand or slavery. Anyone who does deserves to die. Our needs are aligned.
What kind of defenses would these two have?
I haven't the faintest idea, but they're certain to be armed. Their partnership soured, and each believes that the other intends to kill him. They will be well prepared.
I think I'm gonna do this.
If they're as bad as you say they are, they need to be dealt with.
Excellent. Here are the coordinates. When these men are dead, I will wait for you at the third set of coordinates. Goodbye, Commander. It's been a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, but yeah, they have killing her. Yeah, there's my renegade points. System of the Hades Gamma Cluster. Maybe it isn't that one. Still way up here in Barry. Ooh, let's see if he has anything to sell. So much money. Hello.
Commander.
Show me your items.
Oh, this one is pleased to do so.
I think I already like spent like a ton of money. Yeah, the Corian armor. Yeah, bro. Wait, did you?
Commander.
Show me your items.
Good. Oh, this one is pleased.
Oh. Dally, got you a present. The upgrade here, there you go. Still have tons of money.
Hello again, Commander.
Welcome. It is a pleasure to see you. You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
Oh, it's gonna open up. Yep. Okay. I think we're going to call it a night here. We will take this fast transit back to.
I see even the humans find the consort irresistible.
And we'll do the quick transport or rapid transit back to CSEC. We're gonna call it a day here. Thank you very much for watching. My next stream is gonna be Wednesday night instead of Tuesday. Tuesday's Valentine's Day, so me and my girlfriend, we're not going out. We have some plans. So Wednesday night, I'm gonna be back to my quirky indie games. Don't know what I'm gonna play yet. I still have to figure that out. I did finish off the next big thing last week, so it'll be a new game this week. Then after that, I'll be streaming Friday night, 9. Don't know what I'm going to play then. Actually, what I may do then is... Yeah. So I'll have a week to think about that there. Yeah, I know, it's fun. You don't what I'm going to be playing. And then next Sunday will be more of Mass Effect. And so maybe we'll go do Vermeier next week. Or should we go take out the... Let's go do Vermeier. Let's make some kind of progress on the story again next week, because I didn't do any of that this week. So that's it. Thank you for watching. This video is going to be uploaded onto YouTube like usual at youtube.com/user/fscornia. And good night. And good week, everybody.